Water and Environmental Engineering Research Group.
What we do is we build, we develop, we use and test computer models to simulate the water environment. We have a very complementary group of researchers in the area of water so that we can address all areas of the hydrologic cycle, including the connection to society, quite well within one group. We have a strong focus on computational aspects, so we build and use models. We are very strong in developing new methods for estimating the uncertainty in these predictions so that we can really understand much better how these predictions are useful for decision makers, for policy makers. And we also more recently started implementing and using new types of sensors that now allow us to measure our environment at scales much more relevant for society and for research.
So as Thorstein mentioned, in order to support those models that we help develop, we sometimes need to validate them or compare with what we see out in the field. What I've been working more recently is to try and develop and use cosmic ray soil moisture sensors that use neutrons from cosmic rays that interact with the hydrogen in the soil. Trying to combine soil moisture with flood forecasting or drought for drought predictions in using those numerical models we use. So the novelty of this sensor is because it gives you soil moisture at an unprecedented scale, which is about 300 meter radius and integrated. So you have that volume for that volume that's much more relevant to our hydrological processes.
One thing that is changing in the UK is the research environment and the questions we're addressing. So for example, we get pushed more and more into integrated water resources management. The term has been around for a long time, but it hasn't really been implemented because there was no need to implement it properly. Now, with a changing climate, with increasing demands, with bigger diversity in availability and demand of water across the country, that becomes increasingly important. And that means that for us, we move into the areas of water management. We build more connected models. Through a lot of our modeling efforts, we try to bring in together different models, whether that's a health model and an ecosystem model and a water model or a mobility model, so that we can look at these integrated problems and provide the tools and methods that industry will need, in some cases already needs, to address this complex water problem that we're increasingly facing.
How these individual catchments behave if there is a...
One of the things I find particularly interesting is the growing interdisciplinarity of the kind of projects we're working on. So, for example, we work with the veterinary and health people on how water moves pathogens and people or animals get infected. We work with the mobility modelers to look at how under emergency situations, for example, flooding in a city, pathways to hospitals and emergency services are cut off. We work with the Met Office to use their data and translate the climate or weather predictions into floods or droughts, the impact on society. So it's these kind of projects where we really try to connect to society directly, and we bring the science and the engineering to the table, and then we use other people to bridge to decision makers or to other aspects of the problem that we can't address directly.
Because we deal with water resources systems, and water is used by many different people for different uses, we have also to support policymakers in analyzing the trade-offs between possible different uses of water. So for instance, if you have a reservoir or water supply system, on the one hand, you have to account for a reliable water supply to industry, to people, maybe for hydropower production, but then on the other end you also have to take into consideration conservation of the environment, because we abstract waters from rivers and this impacts the ecosystems. And therefore what we do is provide the knowledge and the tools to analyze the trade-off between these different possible uses of water.
One of the areas where water research at the University of Bristol is one of the leading groups is in the area of modeling, in particular modeling connected to estimating uncertainty in the predictions coming from environmental models that we're using for a wide range of societal problems. We work, for example, with experimental psychologists here at the University of Bristol to understand how people make decisions with uncertain information in a non-stationary world and a world that is changing around them. We live in a rapidly changing world where we have changing climate, we have population growth, we have land use change, which means we need more food for people, we need more water for energy, and we need more energy to produce water, for example, through desalination. With a warmer climate, we have more extreme weather events that leads to more flooding, to more droughts that we've observed in many parts of the world already. And all these societal problems drive our research and drive the scientific questions we're addressing.